Yes. So today's our topic is atrophy. So just simply we will split our word atrophy. A stands for absence and trophy stands for nutrition. So in atrophy, there is reduction in size or absence of nutrition due to that size is reduced. Means this is normal cell, its size is reduced and it is atrophic cells. So commonest example is, we can say in old age also, there is, we can see atrophy. Similar example is like in menopause, after menopause uterus size shrinks, right? Gonads, genitals shrinks, right? It is seen that the size of brain is also shrinks, right? So old age is a common example. And about the causes, what are the causes of atrophy? First cause of atrophy is blood supply, reduced blood supply. If we are eating three chapatis daily and started eating one chapati, so our size will shrink, right? Similarly, if an organ, let it be a liver, if it gets less blood supply due to any other causes, its size will also reduce due to reduced blood supply. Blood is nothing but a nutrition. It carries oxygen, it carries nutrition, and it carries waste product also. So reduced blood supply means reduced oxygen, reduced nutrition, and as we say, if we do dieting, size will reduce. So concept is reduced blood supply, will lead to reduced oxygen, reduced nutrition, and leads to reduce in size or atrophy. In dieting, concept is different. They are telling us to avoid fatty foods. But so just for understanding purpose, I have given this dieting ka example. Coming back, second is functional. If we stop using any organ, it will gradually its size will reduce. It is also called a disused atrophy. For example, it is said that we have evolved from monkey. So we have stopped using our tail and gradually the tail is vanished. So atrophy, size is reduced and now it is gone. Right? So second example, or we can take, is that a fractured limb. After a plaster, when we remove the plaster after maybe 1.5 months or 2 months, after removing the plaster, you can compare normal hand and fractured hand. Fractured hand will have a reduced size. It is due to less movement is there, so less blood supply, less nourishment, so size will reduce, and it is called disused atrophy or a functional atrophy due to this disused or a functional reason, lack of functional reason. Then comes our third point, that is due to nerve damage. It is said if the ceiling fan is there, if we put on the button and if it is not working, so there can be a reason that this wire is not proper, right? So similarly, to function properly, so nerve supply is also very important along with the blood supply. So if there is a damaged nerve supply, for an example, in case of polio, so that leg will be a thin, as there will be no nutrition, as there is nerve supply is damaged, so no movement, no circulation, and slowly the pulp gets shrink. So polio is an example of nerve damage leading to atrophy of affected limb. Fourth point is about endocrine. So there are hormones in our body such as growth hormones, then we can say thyroid hormone, which helps in metabolism. So if metabolism is affected, so particularly atrophy also seen at that point, atrophy of size. So we see the dwarfism, or so size is reduced. due to endocrine. Then last one is pressure, due to pressure. We have seen that in Mumbai local we have so much crowd, so sometimes we get pressed, so our size gets reduced. Similarly, when there is a neoplasm or tumor, it presses the tissues around, nerves around, blood supply around, and ultimately it also gives rise to atrophy of the adjacent cells. So to understand it, to remember it, atrophy is reduced in size. Okay, so simple five reasons we can remember through a mnemonic, that is boyfriend Nepali. Okay, boyfriend, B stands for blood supply, reduced blood supply. Friend, F stands for loss of function. N stands for nerve damage. E stands for endocrine damage. P stands for pressure. And Nepali, we can, N-E-P is there, so we can remember that way. So in this way we can try to remember our topic, that is atrophy. That's it for today. Thank you so much.